I'm Brad Kane, editor of Worcester Business Journal. I'm here with Troy Siebels, president and CEO of Hanover Theater. Hello.
Hello.
Thanks for having me out to the theater today.
Thank you for being here.
I appreciate it. So Troy, in addition to running the business operations basically since the theater started, really 15 years ago since the
nonprofit. That's right.
You've also directed.
I direct our Christmas Carol every year.
Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol.
That's right.
So, which I'm sure you, it's a classic, but you also want to have like an interesting take on it. Right? So
absolutely. It there's a million interpretations out there, but ours is, it wants to be fun at the holidays, right? You want to go out and have fun and get the holiday spirit.
So, Christmas Carol's not inherently fun, being about death and, you know, being mean to old people, being mean to poor people. So how do you make it fun?
You find humor in everything. You know, just talking, just rehearsal this year, looking at Scrooge counting his money while his nephew is trying to convince him of the value of being charitable at Christmas, and just the sound he's making by putting coins in his box is overpowering the words the other guy's made. It's just funny trying to watch him get a word in edgewise, but it's just funny. You know, it's just the little things. You just find your things all the way through as you do it that just turn out funny from the audience. It doesn't mean they're funny to Scrooge, but they're funny to us watching.
And I remember I saw the performance this year, and when his partner, who's the ghost, comes in, this is quite the theatrical scene where chains are falling from the ceiling and he flies in. But that was also hilarious. Was that your direction, or was it the actor?
I think it was a little of both. It's absolutely, it was a little of both. And you think about what it would be like for you if you were sitting in your bedroom and somebody flew through the wall, right, hanging from chains from the ceiling. And it's hard to quite imagine what that would be like, right? Because it's sort of outside the bounds of reality. But it's you kind of go to humor pretty quickly, you know? What would be funny about that? Well, this isn't possible. This can't be happening. And so maybe there's some denial in that too, right? Well, not this. This isn't happening. It's also so hugely dramatic, you know? The power of that. Him coming in, Ebenezer Scrooge flying down, all the smoke and all the power, looking down at Scrooge, and what can Scrooge say? Almost anything he says is going to be anticlimactic after that, and so you might as well play with that.
Nice.
Yeah.
Sounds like, so, you said your favorite role is in the whole play?
Well, Scrooge, I mean, the central role, I think. That was the most fun. It's the story revolves around him, and it's all about taking the audience on his path, so we feel things and see things the way he sees them. And so that's the most interesting. It was the most fun to cast. We looked around Boston area, Worcester and Boston area, and we ultimately went to New York to cast it. We saw a bunch of agents submitted folks, and we watched a dozen probably performers. And Jeremy was the very first person we saw. Jeremy Lawrence is our Scrooge. He was there about 10 minutes before our reader was there to help read with him for the audition. So we sat around and talked for a little while beforehand, and it was kind of fun getting to know him. And he later said that just being around talking was the most fun. He thought the audition went horribly, and he was totally surprised when he got a call a week later and we offered him the job. He's great. He's like the quintessential Ebenezer Scrooge. He's great.
So what's his take on the character that really stood out to you?
He's really sympathetic to the character. He, you know, and I'm with him on this. He's not trying to be a bad guy. He's trying to be a nice guy. He's trying to be reasonable. It's just what he thinks is reasonable isn't the same as most of the other people in the play think is reasonable. He's trying to do the right thing, you know, and it's just that the way the things that he's experienced in his life or he's been brought up thinking are in conflict with what everybody else thinks is a nice guy.
All right. Well, anything else you want to add about the play? Everyone should obviously go see it.
Obviously, in
November, December?
It's December. Okay. It's the second week of December every year, and we're not even on sale yet. We'll figure it out. We're going to figure out what we're going to do differently this year. We change it a little bit every year, so there'll be some new.
This is the 11th year, right?
This will be the 11th year. That's right. It's hard to live up to our own bar, but we will. We will.
Sounds good. Looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Troy. Again, this is Brad Kane here with Troy Siebels, Hanover Theater.